And you're ready to flow.
Once you're past the flumes, there's hundreds of sharp, jagged rocks, both above and below the water, to look out for.
The River Stour was the original boundary between the East Saxons, Essex, and the South Folk, Suffolk.
What are we going there?
That's an island.
We pushed on to lunch at Stratford St Mary, famous for the origins of its pubs.
Free coaching in Skua is a result of increased trade traffic towards London.
These were the Anchor, the Swan, and the Black Horse.
The Anchor had 20 acres of pasture for cattle bound for the London market. The Swan had extensive stabling from those following the harvest from north to south. The Black Horse has connections with highwayman Matthew Keys. He was hung in 1751 on Kennington Common. He left his watch here once as a pledge for reckoning.
After lunch at the Swan, we left in one piece. Just.
Talbooth restaurant was originally a pair of cottages with their own quay and lime kiln. It was first described as the Talbooth in 1659.
This is because chalk was brought by barge from Great Cornard and coal from Manningtree and Mistley. These goods were weighed here and tolls charged for the upkeep of the tall, narrow toll bridge.
Going under the A12 means that we've entered Dedham Vale, John Constable country.
Our first stop is at the lock, in the village of Dedham.
Most houses in the Dedham High Street received a dramatic facelift in times of Georgian prosperity. The perfect example of this modernisation is behind me at Sherman's. It's worth saying a little about the Sherman family, whose remarkable history goes way beyond Dedham.
The first known Sherman to settle in Dedham was Henry S. Sherman, who arrived in 1532 and established a successful cloth business. Wool trade here was one of the wealthiest in the country. His descendants were some of the first to emigrate to America in the 1630s and became part of its everlasting history. It was a Sherman who helped to draw up and then sign the Declaration of Independence on July 4th, 1776. Later, as Commander-in-Chief of the US Army, General William T. Sherman brought the Civil War to a close by his famous march through the southern states, and it is this Sherman that gave his name to the infamous Sherman tanks from World War II. A tangible reminder of the long years of school use can still be seen in the many initials carved by Georgian and Victorian schoolboys. But enough of the history lesson, let's get back to the river.
Some of Suffolk's most celebrated countryside. Constable returned time and time again to the next few hundred metres of water to paint some of the most celebrated pictures in English art history.
John Constable was born in East Bergholt in 1776 to Anne and Golding Constable. His father was a wealthy corn merchant, owning Flatford and Dedham Mill. John was expected to carry the business on. However, in his youth, John was introduced to art and painting. By 1799, John entered the Royal Academy School. Constable adopted a routine of spending his winters in London, and summers were spent in East Bergholt.
Well, we've just passed under Flatford Bridge.
These scenes, in his own words, made me a painter, and I am grateful. The sound of water escaping from a mill, dams, etc. Willows, old rotten planks, slimy posts, and brickwork. I love such things. John Constable was making something rather beautiful out of the River Stour. He captured a combination of water, scenery, and the people who live by. Tranquility is an important factor to bear in mind.
Flatford Lock, the final stop on the way to Catterwade.
David Attenborough, playing up.
You come in here, I'll go in there.
No sprint star for me today.